10.
Ah, leave me alone.
Wake up, or you'll miss the show.
Show's over, boy. He's as good as dead.
Say, Tim, how many shots do you have left in your rifle?
Two, why do you ask?
I've got one. That makes three.
But why should that be any of our damn business?
I got an idea we can make something out of it. They wouldn't be so interested in that poor guy unless it was worth the trouble. I reckon I'll have a look.
All right, but be quick about it. The coffee's ready.
John Brown's body lies a-moldering in the grave.
But his soul goes marching home. No.
Not bad at all, eh?
Hey! Come on out! The danger's over!
Congratulations. You shoot good. To what do I owe your trouble, senor?
I don't know, but at least you might say thank you.
Thank you. But tell me, why all your trouble?
Well, tell you the truth. I expected a reward. After all, I did save your life, and I even used up my last three bullets for you.
It's only right. There.
Is this a joke?
No, no, it's no joke. But it's all I have. And I'm glad to give it to you, senor. I mean it.
Are you trying to tell me that those guys went to all that trouble for only these $2?
No, of course not.
Then what did they want? Why were they out to plug you?
What do you think about that? I owe my life to you, and right away you want to know everything. Well, they wanted some information. And I wouldn't give it to them. And now, if you don't mind, tell me, how do you get to the nearest village?
Why, certainly. At the end of that trail, you'll find Silverbell, the Pearl of New Mexico.
Mm-hmm. Thanks for everything. And who knows? Maybe I can be of use to you someday, Adios, senor.
I'm going to set you free, my little friend.
That was a smart idea you had, huh? Ooh, he's a smart businessman, he is. For a dollar, I'd go unload crates at Silver Bell. But no, you're so smart, you have to do things your own way, huh?
You know what we'll do now? We'll go to Silver Bell.
To unload crates? I was only just trying to be funny.
We'll go and drink up the dollar. It's hot, and I could go for a good beer.
Morning, Miss Ferguson.
Howdy, Tricky.
The usual.
Yes, sir.
buy me a drink?
Why should I?
Mr. Ferguson?
Three kings. I think I've had enough.
May I?
Huh? Sure, sit down.
I reckon this gentleman would like to play this hand with me alone.
But I'm losing. I got to win back my $80.
I said I'm playing alone.
Excuse me.
I'll see you later, huh, baby?
Two beers.
Tall glasses?
Two beers, I said.
In tall glasses.
Now I hear you.
I could brain him.
Hey, Tim. In the middle of trouble again.
Looks like your luck's worn out, senor.
Think you're right. Don't know the other. But I don't think he's the type I'd care to play poker with.
No one would ever play poker with you, and you know it. Long as I've known you, you've never possessed more than $1.75. Let's go. My friend seems to be in sort of a fix again.
$50.
Call you.
3/8.
3/10. I'm sorry, my boy.
Dirty work. Huh? Making signs behind my back, Ringo.
What do you mean by that, you skunk?
Hey, let go!
Work, old man. Satisfied now? Before we get into any real trouble, let's get out of here before it's too late.
What for? I think Silverbell's got a good impression of us now. Pick him up. We'll go put him to bed. Will you give me the key to a room?
Yes.
Two. Thank you.
Sure. Yeah.
What do I do with this? Can you make it? Now will you explain what you're going to do with this guy?
Can't you see he's bleeding to death? First thing, we have to bandage him.
Hey, Ringo, look. His back's tattooed. Some sort of map. Wonder what it is.
Huh? I don't know. Let's ask him when he wakes. Anyway, it looks like a good job. Bandage him.
You see, the army is useful sometimes. That's where I learned how to draw geographical maps.
Oh, it's you again. What is this place?
The Grand Hotel. By the way, I wasn't able to write your name in the register. What's your name?
Fidel. For now. And yours?
Ringo. For now. You sure seem to like getting into trouble all the time. You need taken care of like a baby.
The dirty, cheating swindler. But why you keep saving my skin?
Your skin interests me. Especially the skin on your back. You know, we don't like going around sticking our nose in another man's business, even if we've saved his life twice in a few hours. But when he goes around with a nice design on his back, he begins to interest us. What is it? Some kind of a game?
Give me that map. You got no right to it.
There, you see? You're in no condition to get excited. Now listen to me. Alone, you're never going to manage to make it, and you've proven it. But you had the good fortune to meet two honest people. I think the right thing to do is to have confidence and tell us your whole story. Not that we want you to do anything you wouldn't want. But something tells me you're going to need two practical men like Tim and me.
And what if I don't?
Well, we'll take care of you till you get well. But I have an idea you're in a big hurry.
All right, then. Hey. A cigarette. After all, I owe you my life. And what I have to do is better to do it in three. And not alone. It's a long story. Began in Mexico. 2 years ago. But El Paso. For reasons I don't want to explain right now, amigo, I was in jail. In the same cell with a Yankee friend of mine. And an old Mexican bandido. The famous Badia. Known as Guanabano. One day, while out in the air, Guanabano was beaten by some prisoners over some quarrel of the past. And we pitched in and saved his life. But he was in very bad condition. In spite of all our efforts, after a few days, he died. In his own way, Guanabano was a man of honor. He wanted to pay his debt to us by giving us the map of a place where he had hidden a big treasure. Two bags of gold dust he had robbed 2 years earlier from a lucky gold seeker, and which Guanabano had then hidden in a secret cave. A few months later, my American friend was let out of prison, and so we separated. With the understanding that when I got out too, we'd go in search of the treasure. So he destroyed Guanabano's map. After having half of it tattooed on his back and half on mine. You see, that way, I could be certain my friend would wait for me.
A very interesting story, that. I haven't heard one like it in years. Well, we'll help you find your American friend.
But I know where to find him.
We could follow you, and then once we get the other half of the map, get rid of you.
Maybe we could even get rid of your friend.
We'll do it together. I'm not ungrateful. And I'm willing to give each one of you a share of 10%. We'll find my friend and I'll explain the situation. After we find the treasure, we'll divide it four ways, according to what I said.
Five ways, gentlemen, if you don't mind. You know, I'm not inclined to eavesdrop in other people's conversation, but if you consider that my room is right next to this one, you were talking with rather loud voices. This affair interests me, and I've decided to participate.
Is that so? And what makes you think we'll accept making you a part of this deal? Is it because of the two bullets you have in that gun?
Oh, no, it was only a precaution. Oh, no, you see, the fact is, I've got a lot of friends in this town. You must have noticed it. Good men, but very vindictive. And after what happened a little while ago, I'd swear they're thinking up a way to get rid of the three of you. And that would be just too bad for the two sacks of gold dust. The more I think of it, there's only one way for you to get out of this town alive. They must see you all leave together with me, like we were old friends. I don't mind doing you the favor, but it'll cost you plenty. Maybe one of you is thinking of the possibility of getting rid of me and getting away. Come. Take a look. No need to worry. As long as you're with me, nobody out there will dare to move.
Yeah. By the way, Fidel, there's one thing you haven't told us. How did those Mexicans yesterday know about the map on your back?
I thought you guessed it. One was the man who made the tattoo, and the others were the brothers of his wife. Simple, isn't it?
Looks like those men are waiting for us. Fidel, are you sure that countryman of yours had only two relatives?
I forgot to tell you. Those are three friends of mine who will follow us until such time that there's more trust between us. After all, now that I've gotten you safely out of town, you might very easily try to get rid of me as one too many. I've never counted too much on the gratitude of men, so I had to take my precautions. But don't worry. They'll be very discreet and behave themselves like real gentlemen. And anyway, I'm not expecting them to get a share.
Down that way. A half hour ride. It's better if they don't see us together, eh? We'll make our headquarters in that deserted shack over there. It's a pretty safe place. Is that all right?
All right. Hey.
My friend is a reasonable man. It won't be difficult to come to an understanding. I will go to town and come back here with him in an hour.
Excuse me, Fidel, but I'm not in agreement. I believe that your friends think like I do. You go into town, you talk with your friend, and what happens? You look each other in the face and you realize that you have no more need for us. All right, that's fine. All you have to do is put your backs together and the gold's yours. That's easy to figure, isn't it?
Well, Ringo and me could go.
But that would change nothing because you have Fidel's drawing. No, honestly, you must recognize the only one who can go is me. What can we do? Fidel's man and myself with only half a map. Doesn't my way seem reasonable to you? A guarantee for everyone.
Well, maybe you're right. What do you think, Fidel, huh?
All right. You must go and look for Sam Dellinger, the sheriff. Yes. My friend had himself elected sheriff of San Luis. I don't know how, considering that no one could swear to his honesty, but you know how these things happen. When you tell him you were sent by Fidel of El Paso, he'll understand immediately.
You people just trust old Tricky. He knows how to handle these affairs.
Come on, Sam, be reasonable. $2 apiece is almost what I'd earn selling the cattle. After all you have to do is to close an eye like the other times. If we want to make the deal, I say that a dollar...
Shut up, Mortimer. You know damn well that your cattle is diseased and that according to law, I had them slaughtered right down to the last one. Instead, I'm letting you sell them as if they was healthy. Listen, don't you think I know what you earn in this deal? Don't try to be too smart with me, Mortimer. Wait. Come on in. What do you want? The office is closed.
I know, Sheriff, sir, but you see, it's an urgent matter and I saw your light.
What is it? Come on, I haven't time to lose.
Very well. It won't take much time. I've come on behalf of Fidel, of El Paso.
Just a moment. All right, Mortimer. Come back tomorrow and we'll talk it over.
But Sam, tomorrow's too late.
Shut up, Mortimer. Get out. I said come back tomorrow.
Don't get angry. All right, Sheriff, all right.
Your job's a pretty tough one, Sheriff, but I see you know how to make them respect you and you don't take any arguments.
You gotta treat them like that or they take advantage of you. Have a drink?
Thanks.
What about Fidel?
Oh, he's a fine fellow, all right. Has one defect, he talks too much. Now there are three of us besides you two who are in on your little secret. Too many, don't you think?
Where's Fidel now?
Not so fast, my friend. He's not alone. The other two who are with him are a little difficult. They know how to shoot.
Yeah, I get you. I'm sure we can come to an agreement.
Yes, I'm sure that we can come to some kind of an agreement.
You know what I was thinking? I don't like those three men at all. I don't like the idea of having them always out there on our heels.
Me too. It sure wasn't fair, Tricky, to drag those guys along.
Yeah. So long as he has their protection, he could always play us a dirty deal.
Well, we still have over an hour before he comes back from town, huh?
That gives us more than enough time to get out there and persuade those three to get out of here. Don't you think?
Let's go persuade. Howdy, boys. My friends and I thought we'd just come out and have a little talk with you.
Your boss plumb forgot to introduce us.
There's nothing to talk about. We don't want you here.
We feel sorry for you, hombres. Especially after what Tricky told us.
What did Tricky say?
That you fellas are working for him. Free.
I reckon you must have plenty of good reason to ride all day and sleep in the open at night without so much as a thank you.
Damn skunk. He wants to trick us.
Here. Mind if I have a drink, huh? Thanks. I'd beat it if I was in your place.
I'd do it if I were you.
Listen, why didn't you get the hell out of here? And fast.
I don't think you get the point, boy. You're the one's gonna get the hell out of here and fast. No tricks. Take the guns, Tim.
Take it easy. I'll take care of it.
Find him?
He'll be here soon.
Did he greet everything?
Mm-hmm. Seems like it. What happened to my men?
Why? Did something happen? Huh?
Yeah, somebody shot him. They're full of lead.
That's so. Thought I heard some shooting here about. I can't imagine who done it.
Yeah, I figured that.
There's someone who wants to give us a surprise. Didn't you tell him to come alone?
He assured me that he would.
Don't move or I'll shoot. Cover the other one. He's right away. They've got us trapped.
Through the back door.
I'm going to take a look outside.
You know nothing about it, is that right, Ricky?
So he told you he was coming alone, eh?
I think they're all dead, except one who escaped toward the town. Fidel, see if your sheriff friend is among the dead. Well, Tricky, what do you got to say?
You're all idiots. You really believe that if I'd made a deal with the sheriff, I'd have come back here to be picked off by the first revolver shot? What would have stopped me from staying hidden until the sheriff and his men got you out of the way? Look, it's easy now to suspect me. But wouldn't I have thought of that? If I had made a deal with the sheriff? And why? To divide everything with him and the five or six members of his gang?
He's not there. He must have been the one who escaped.
What do you think he's up to now, Fidel?
I need every one of you. A group of bandits are hiding in a shack nearby, ready to attack our town and sack your home. They've already killed five of my men. I was lucky enough to get away alive. The time has come to show that we got guts. You must catch them by surprise. Come on, mount your horses. Follow me.
Thank you.
leave our horses here. We must move up silently. The shack's over there.
Skunk wants to reach an agreement with us?
I have a strange feeling that your friend doesn't love you anymore, Fidel.
Come on out, you worm. I got 30 men waiting to give you a warm welcome. Drop your guns and come out one at a time. I'm counting up to three. Then I'm going to give the order to fire. One. Two. Search him.
Sam. This isn't according to the pact we made.
Why don't you fight like men, you rat?
Hold it. Stop. We'll hang them, but only after we have a trial. Tie them up. We'll take them into town.
It won't help much, but thanks just the same, son.
But it will help. Ringo, have you got the copy of the map with you?
I hid it in a safe place. I defy anybody to find it.
Good. Then we can still hope to get out of here alive. Everything now depends entirely on you, Fidel.
Me? What way?
There's only one thing to do to force Sam Dillinger to deal with us. I know it's not pleasant, Fidel, but we have no other choice. Figure it out. Sam knows very well you've got that map tattooed on your back. All he has to do is come here, copy it, and he has no need for you or us anymore. And the bags of gold will be his. And the four of us will find permanent domicile in the San Luis Cemetery. But if, on the other hand, you listen to reason, he won't be able to harm us anymore because he's going to need us. Besides, we have a copy of the map hidden somewhere. All we have to do is make your tattoo disappear. Come on.
All right, I'll do it.
Hold him, boys.
Oh.
What did you do to him? Have you all gone crazy?
No, we haven't, Sheriff, and you damn well know it. I'd say the moment has arrived for us all to have a little chat.
Don't you know that in 12 hours you'll all be swinging on rope?
Will that really console you, brother, for losing all that gold?
Well, it's all a matter of taste. Am I right?
And I guess you know, Sheriff, that we've hidden a copy of Fidel's map somewhere.
All right. What do you propose?
First, get us out of here fast.
Secondly, you must do it in a way so those bandits who you should teach to have respect for the law won't lynch us.
Thirdly, you must enter this here partnership under the conditions that we're now putting up to you.
Yeah, well, what are those conditions?
20% for each. Things being how they are, one can't do otherwise.
Suppose I don't give a damn about my 20% and hang all four of you.
I don't think so. You like money too much. And you know damn well that hangings can be had at a much better price. Besides, there's another particular. Yesterday evening after leaving you, I gave a letter to someone with instructions to send it on to the federal authorities if he didn't hear from me within 2 days. Do you want to know what was written in that letter? Well, it mentions diseased cattle that belongs to certain breeders who want to get along very well with their sheriffs.
All right. I accept. I'll let you out tonight. When the coast is clear, you can go get your map. Then we meet 1 hour later at any place you want.
One moment there. How do we know you come to this meeting alone?
You're right. Then we'll do it this way. Of you three, which is the best shooter?
Why, Ringo.
Very well. You tell me the place where you want us to meet tonight. And from that moment, Ringo will stay with me to check that I don't approach anybody.
Think you can do it, Ringo?
Sure I can.
Just Ringo now. It must look like a job done from the outside. Where do we meet?
At the river bend.
All right, in an hour. Stay there, away from the window.
Ringo, keep your eyes open.
Simpler to come out together.
I don't want to burn all my bridges behind me. Well, what's the matter? Don't you trust me anymore? Be ready now. The horses are tied up over there. Good. Now all we have to do is wait till it's all clear.
Town is on the search for us. And without a sheriff, if they find us now, you can bet they're not going to bring us to trial before hanging us.
Sure you shot him dead?
I'm sure. At such a distance, I couldn't possibly have missed
him. I was crazy to bring you with me. Alone, I could have made out better.
Shut up. You'd never have made it by yourself. You'd already be a dead duck.
Sam Dellinger, what a loss to his country. But he can still be useful to us.
Sam Dellinger, allow me for once to speak without interrupting. You are not a good sheriff, nor even what is called a good man, but the Lord is merciful, and who knows, he may forgive you. For this, we pray from the bottom of our hearts, Sam, and that is all.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Shut up!
Will somebody kindly explain what's going on around here?
Certainly, Tim. It means somebody beat you to it.
You did it, you dirty swindler! Give me that map or you'll end up in that coffin.
Let him go, Tim. Come on, Tricky. Give me that map and don't argue, Tricky.
What? I don't have it, Ringo. You can search me if you don't believe me. I don't need one because I have an excellent memory. Therefore, I have the first part of the map and you have the second. Now I feel much safer because you really need me. Unless you want to find Sam's body.
And have you thought of what might happen, Tricky, when we get to my portion of the map?
Something'll happen. But in the meantime, just remember it's a long way.
Here we are in my country. This is the part that's most difficult.
Why were you in prison, Fidel? You seem like an honest man.
It's none of your business. I never ask questions.
Fidel, you are wrong to be against me. Don't you realize that as long as we're divided, those two will get the best of us?
Just let them try it. They'll have to answer to this.
There are two of them, and they also have that. If instead you and I agree, come on, don't tell me that you find a four-way split a pleasure.
Thank you.
to stab me in the back. Why don't you try it now and do it like a man?
No, Tim, no. I didn't want to. It was tricky. You told me to do it.
Don't move. Double-crosser. Disarm him, Tim.
I think it's time we got rid of that snake. So long as he's around, we're only going to have trouble.
No, Tim. We're not the kind who kill people like that. Now, you listen to me, Tricky. And you too, Fidel. I advise you not to try it ever again. Tim and I are the only ones who have guns. And next time, we're going to shoot. You can count on that.
Partners has left us.
Yeah, forever, I hope.
That boy's nerves were a bit ragged. Good. The percentage goes up. A third for each of us.
Look, muchachos, today we eat.
We reign at the Chito Igu, Abelito Morales. We
eat today.
Joaquin, the people in this town are good. Why do we treat them like this?
Manuel! Manuela! Cook them!
Yes, but I won't kill them.
Don't worry, Manuela. I'll do it. Killing is the kind of work I like to do. Don't even hear you, stupid dog!
Paco, you're a pig.
I may be a pig, but I'm also the boss here. And don't forget that, Joaquin. If she wasn't your sister, you'd look at her like that, too.
Salud, Fidel. Welcome home.
Well, well, what a surprise. The prodigal son comes back to the roof. Too bad we have no fatted calf.
Well, you don't look like you got richer since I left you.
You don't look like it either.
I could let you earn $500.
No.
That's too bad. Well, you stay here and rot in this stinking hole with your men and lose a good chance. All right. Maybe it will be for another time, huh? Adios, Paco.
Fidel! Wait, what's your hurry? I've got a bottle of tequila.
Hey, listen, Tricky. I think you made a mistake.
Why, there could be a town here.
Take a look up there. If this town exists, I'll be able to see it.
If it amuses you.
What's the matter?
There's some men down there waiting for us. They're armed.
How many?
Too many. Come on.
Ha! Here.
They have seen us. To the horses.
Two of you stay here. We'll surround them. Anda!
Have you been keeping count?
Watch out!
I'll get him.
Forgotten that one.
I think it's safe to go down, fellas.
Doesn't seem like there's a living soul in this damn town.
Better this way. Judging by their welcome, they can't be very sociable people.
Look.
Welcome, senores. I don't know why you have done it, but we are grateful for you liberating Santo Agustin from a band of criminals who oppressed it. For many months, this band of thieves has made their headquarters in our town, robbing us of everything. We would like to repay you in some manner, but everything we had has been taken away from us.
I'm Tim. I'd be satisfied with something to eat and something to drink. If anyone ever told me I was going to be the liberator of San Agustin, I told him he was crazy.
Something I'd really like to know is why those bandits were after our skins.
Maybe Fidel could explain it. I'll bet he knows something about it.
Oh. Here.
Hmm? Hmm. Hey, kids. Come on, boys. Come over here. That's right. Don't be bashful. Come over here. Come here. What's your name, huh? Don't you want to tell me your name, huh? Hmm? What is it?
Miguel.
Ah, Miguel. And my name's Tim. You like it? Good boy. You want something to eat?
Huh.
Well, why not? Take it.
Gotcha, Senor Tim.
How was that?
Why, certainly. Here you are.
There. Oh, no, you can be charitable with your own goods.
Here, catch. What happened now?
She's a witch. She was the woman of them all.
What do y'all want? Leave her alone.
Inside. Get out of here. Now, no violence. And if she's done anything bad, I promise you, she'll be well punished. Now, get on your way. Tell me, what have those folks got against you? Is it true you were with the bandits?
No.
No? Why do they want to kill you? Are you really a witch?
No.
Here, give her this.
No. They want to kill me because I am the sister of Joaquin.
And who's Joaquin?
One of the men you killed. He was working with Paco, the leader of the bandits. But I did nothing wrong. I only lived with him because I had nobody else in the world. He fed me and protected me. And I loved him, even if he was a bandit. And now that he's gone, they'll kill me.
Oh, no. You'll see. They'll leave you in peace.
You don't know them. They'll kill me if I stay here.
Well, what do you want to do then?
I'll come with you.
With us? We don't even know where we're going.
It doesn't matter. You must take me along with you, senor. Joaquin was everything to me, and you killed him, so you must take me with you. I'll be your servant. I'll do anything you want. But don't leave me here.
That's enough. Tricky. Let her go or I'll split your head wide.
What's on your mind? Now, surely you don't mean to bring her along.
I think we ought to bring her along. You don't think so, but there are three in this deal. We better get us an opinion from Tim.
Well, I think Ringo's right. We can't leave her here.
Water's all finished. Give me your flask.
I lost it during the fighting, but Tricky's got some
water. It is not stated anywhere in our agreement that I have to give you my water.
Please, give the flask to me.
What are you going
to
do?
I know how to find water. There's plenty around if you know how to find it.
Wait. I want to see how you do it.
What a moving scene, the Beauty and the Beast. You have scruples, old man, but you're wrong. The girl belongs to all three of us, and I gladly give my part to you.
You talk too much, Tricky, and I don't want to hear you. Why don't you go to sleep and leave me alone?
Or do you prefer that I give it to Ringo in exchange for a few ounces of gold? He'd be very happy. Huh. Here, the night is very cold. Why don't you drink this? My map finishes here, and this is where your part of the map should begin.
It's that way. Come on. It's not very far away. About 4 days riding, I reckon.
Let's search for water, see if I've learned how to find it.
What can you do, Tim? You see, that's life. Ringo's young. He's a good-looking boy. It's natural for the girl to fall in love. What do you expect?
Don't give a damn about her.
Oh, anyone can tell from the look in your face that that girl is really burning you up. I don't see what the problem is. Manuela belongs to all three of us. She said she'd do anything, didn't she? Why all this concern for Ringo, who's already enjoyed his share?
Go to sleep now, Tim. It's my turn.
Ringo? How many years has it been you and I have been together now?
10 years, I reckon. But why are you asking that?
10 years. Long time for an old man like me. I guess you know. You're the only one I have in the world.
Come on, old fella. Don't get sentimental. Go to sleep. You're tired.
Send him away, Ringo boy. I'm asking you. Send him away before something awful happens.
Who gave you this bottle of liquor?
It's Tricky. Tricky gave it to me. He's not a bad man. He gave it without asking.
You mustn't drink any more, Tim. And if he gives you any, you oughtn't to drink it. Tim, I'm sorry to have to say this, but it's better for all of us. Give me the map you have.
Hmm?
Give me the map.
The map. Certainly. Certainly, Ringo. It'd be a lot safer if you would, if you'd hold it.
I think it's best, Tim. Tomorrow you'll be all right.
Ugh.
What do you want, Fidel? I thought you had enough of our partnership.
Take me back with you, Ringo. When I left you, I was crazy to do it. It was all Tricky's fault.
No, Fidel. We don't want you, my friend.
But you can't do this. The map was mine. The treasure belongs to me, Ringo.
Just a minute. Those bandits, who sent them against us? Who told Paco there was something to be made out of this? How much did you promise him for our lives?
I don't know anything. I don't know what bandits you're talking about.
It was all a dream then. Get out of here. We don't want you with us. Get the hell out of here. Go on.
Tim! Tim, forgive me. Forgive me. I didn't mean to do it. I didn't. My friend, I killed him.
No, Ringo. The fault is all mine. I was the cause of destroying your friendship. Now you are going to hate me. I will go away.
That's why Tricky ran away. He's got the drawing. But it's not important anymore. You can have the whole damn treasure. He'd say he was gonna die like a prairie dog. And that the prairie dogs would have a good meal on him. And he'd say that's what he wanted. Because that's all he deserved. But it's not true. Tim was a good man. It was he who taught me everything that I know. For 10 years, he was like a father to me. You'd have to know him to understand what kind of a man he was. That's what he wanted to tell me before he died. He wanted to tell me he had the map. That means that he forgave me before he died. And he still wanted to help me. Tim has forgiven me. He was still my friend when he died. I'll find the gold. Tim would have wanted me to. I will do it for him.
Howdy, friend. Can you spare any water for 4 thirsty travelers?
She sure is beautiful. Where are you taking her?
To Montezuma. This is my wife.
Your wife? I didn't know it was necessary to marry a beautiful woman like that.
Yeah? Well, sometimes you do, you know.
Listen, friend, I didn't mean this kind of mouthwash. You mean to tell me you don't have a bottle of tequila or rum or some other damn thing of the kind?
No, just water.
But maybe you can give us a little bit of money, my friend. What do you got?
Get out of the way and let me pass.
Now, you be careful with that little thing. It might go off and shoot me.
Thank you.
Gold's there unless someone got here before us. You wait out here.
But I don't want you to go in there alone.
But it's better if I go in there alone.
You didn't expect to see me again, right, partner? But we couldn't leave each other just like that after such a long trip. And I met some friends who were also anxious to see you. My friend likes to use his fists. Why don't you accommodate
him? Come on, handsome.
No.
You swine.
We won't hurt you.
No, no, please, stop. No, leave him alone.
I guess he's had enough, Chief. What do we do now?
Yes, that should be enough. Throw him in the ravine.
No! Ringo!
A real love scene.
Get yourself a new love.
Say a prayer of your darling.
Come on, get the hell out of here.
No. Ringo, be careful. He will kill you.
And so have you. Are you afraid of facing me like a man?
All right, Tricky. I'm coming for you.
Listen, Ringo. I'm ready to share. Half for each of us. Why do we have to go on shooting each other with so much gold to divide?
Tricky! No, Tricky. You see, the partnership is ended. I'm afraid it's too late.